We're going to solve a word problem using two variables. Tim used 25 minutes on his cell phone during peak hours and 35 minutes during non-peak hours in May and was charged $10.75. In June, he called 30 minutes during peak hours and 45 minutes during non-peak hours and was charged $13.35. Find the cost per minute during peak hours. All right, now notice that it's only asking for the cost per minute during peak hours, but it's also talking about the minutes during non-peak hours, and we don't know either of those, so we're still going to have to define both the cost per minute during peak hours and the cost per minute during non-peak hours. So let's start with that. So let's let X be the cost per minute during peak hours and Y be the cost per minute during non-peak hours. You could use any variable you want. You might have let P be the cost during peak and N be the cost per minute during non-peak. That's up to you. I went ahead and used X and Y. All right, now notice that we're talking about money and it's given in dollars. I'm going to do this whole problem in cents to avoid the decimals. So on our end, when we find out what X and Y is, it will also be in cents. So we're going to write two equations using the information. Now the first sentence tells us that Tim used 25 minutes during peak. All right, so think about how much that would cost. If the cost for peak was X and he used 25 minutes, then the total for the peak would be 25 times X. So 25X is how much he would have to pay for those peak minutes, but he also has to pay for the time he used in non-peak. So he used 35 minutes during the non-peak hours. 35 minutes. Each minute costs Y cents, right? So he would also have to pay 35 Y. And we know that total is 1075. So that's how we get the first equation. We've got the cost for the peak minutes plus the cost for the non-peak minutes, and that equals 1075 cents, right? Now let's do the same thing for what happened in June. He called 30 minutes during peak hours. Again, 30 by the cost per each minute is X, plus 45 minutes during non-peak hours. So 45, oops, Y, and the total cost was 1335. So, okay, so here's a little trick I use. If I notice there's a common factor in all of the terms on both sides of the equation, I'm going to divide. And hopefully, you notice that 5 goes into all of these numbers in the first equation, and 5 also goes into all the numbers in the second equation. So, in the first equation, I'm just going to divide each side by 5, which means each term gets divided by 5, and that will give me 5x plus 7y equals 215. Then I'm also going to divide in the other equation everything by 5. You might not divide both equations by the same number, but 5 happened to go into all of these numbers as well. So when I divide the right-hand side, I'm sorry, the second equation, each term by 5, I get 6x plus 9y equals 267. All right, so you don't have to do this, but it just lets you work with a little bit easier numbers. All right, well, again, let's see. You could also take this right equation and divide it by 3, because 3 happens to go into 267. If you know the rule for divisibility for 3, if you add the digits, you get 15, and 3 goes into 15, so it goes into 267. So just to make the numbers even a little bit smaller, I'm going to also divide this by 3, and that gives me 2x plus 3y equals 89. I like doing this because I don't like working with large numbers or calculators too much, so if I can, I simplify the problem a little bit. So I've got these two equations, 5x plus 7y equals 215, and 2x plus 3y equals 89. And now, again, it's not easy to solve for x or y, so this is a natural to use the addition method. And we either want the x terms or the y terms to be canceling out, so I have to decide what to multiply top and bottom by. How about if I get the x's to cancel? So that would mean I'd want to multiply the numerator by, let's see, actually, it's easier if I try to get the y's to cancel. I'll multiply the numerator by 2 and the denominator by negative 5, so the x's will cancel. I'll have 10x and minus 10x. So that gives me 10x plus 14y equals 430. And now I've got to multiply everything in the second equation by negative 5. That's the negative 10x minus 15y. Ooh, this is going to be nice. Let's say I got to do negative 5 times 89, which is 445, so it's going to be negative 445. All right, so what's that give us? That gives you negative y equals negative 15, so y is 15. All right, now, since I know y, I can go back up to one of these equations and figure out what x is. How about if I go to this equation right here, and I'm going to put in 15 for y. So that'll give me 2x plus 3 times 15 equals 89. So 2x plus 45 is 89. Subtract 45. So we have 2x equals 44 and x is 22. All right, so hopefully those are the two answers we want. Now we have to go back and see what x and y stood for and go back to the original words and see if this all makes sense. And keep in mind, this whole problem could have been done by keeping the 25x plus 35y equals 1075 and 30x plus 45y times 1335 and do the addition method with just very large numbers, multiplying the numerator, multiplying the first equation by a number and the second equation by a different number. You should still get the same values for x and y. So this was the original problem, and since we came out that x was equal to 22, which stood for the cost per minute during peak, then I've got that the cost per minute during peak was 22 cents, and y was 15, and that stood for the cost per minute during the non-peak. Now we want to go make sure if those are really the right amounts given the original information. So let's check what was said for May. We're going to check May. All right, he used 25 minutes, right? And each of those minutes was 22 cents. I'm going to do this in dollars and cents. So 25 times 22 cents per minute, that gives you 550. And let's see. He also used during May 35 minutes, but those were at the non-peak hour price, 15. And multiplying that out, we have 525. And if we add up, we've got 1075. And it said he was charged 1075. So that certainly checks what was given in May. Now let's see what it says about June. So in June, he used 30 minutes during the non-peak hours, and that was 22 cents a minute, so that's $6.60. And he also used 45 minutes during the non-peak hours, which was 6.75. And then we add that up, and that's 13.35. And the original problem said it was supposed to be $13.35. So therefore, this must be correct. 22 cents per minute during peak, 15 cents during non-peak. The question is find the cost per minute during peak, and here we go. So the cost per minute during peak was 22 cents.